While U.S. oil production revs up, it's a different story at dozens of West Coast ports, where a worker slowdown is costing companies millions of dollars, keeping shipments waiting days or even weeks to be offloaded. Jane Wells has more from the Port of Los Angeles.
It is a traditional bed with contemporary touches on it.
The port problems on the West Coast have gone Hollywood, even affecting actress Jane Seymour.
This is dramatic. You know, this is bringing a piece of old Hollywood into your life.
But if you want to buy it, you may have to wait. Seymour and her partner in the furniture business, Michael Amini, are just two of thousands of businesses impacted by the months-long contract negotiations, which have led to a slowdown in productivity at the nation's largest port complex, Los Angeles and Long Beach. Each side, terminal operators and dock workers, blames the other for the congestion, and Amini is furious.
Every day we are losing money because a lot of consumers, they cancel their order if they can't get it and they go buy something else.
The National Retail Federation says it appears contract talks have come to a screeching halt. Already, Lululemon reduced full-year revenue guidance due to inventory stuck in ports. And Taylor reported it had to ship some goods through more expensive air freight. And FedEx CEO Fred Smith says the port slowdown, quote, has been a much bigger deal than people think.
Amini says he has 23 containers full of furniture stuck on these ships, and to try and reroute that inventory now isn't practical.
It has been very, very challenging.
He said he spent $4 million to be at a recent furniture show to show off new designs.
And it was just the last show that none of our samples made it because it got stuck in port. And it was a pretty big blow to our business.
These are hidden panels.
But from here to the mall to McDonald's, which may have to airlift Idaho potatoes to Japan for French fries, the only good news is the port has not completely shut down like it did in 2002. If that happens again, the National Retail Federation says it could cost the U.S. economy $2 billion a day. For Nightly Business Report, Jane Wells, San Pedro, California.